While we are working on a project, it's highly recommended that we organize the items of our drawing in groups according to the category they fall into. In AutoCAD, those groups are called layers. In order to manage layers, we have to open the Layer Properties palette. We can open this palette either from the Format menu or from the Layers panel of the Home ribbon by clicking the Layer Properties button. Once it's open, there is a list with all the existing layers. Every time we create a new drawing, there is one layer by default, and this is the zero layer. Sometimes you may notice another layer which is called Definition Points. The Definition Points layer is a standard system layer that is automatically generated when a dimension is created in the drawing. The objects on this layer are visible in the drawing area, but will not appear when we plot our drawing. So it's not a good practice to use this layer while drawing. In the current drawing, some dimensions have already been created, so as you can see, this layer is already in the list. Apparently, four more layers have been created: walls, windows and doors, dimensions, and layer 1. To create a new layer, I will click on the New Layer button. I will type the word furniture and press Enter to define the name. I should mention that if I right-click on a layer, I can rename it or even delete it. For example, I will select layer 1, right-click on it, and then select the Delete option. Alternatively, I could have clicked on the Delete Layer icon. As long as the layer doesn't contain objects, it will be deleted. In the same way, I could change the name of the selected layer by clicking on the Rename option. However, note that you cannot delete or rename the default layers, which are the Zero layer and the Definition Points layer. In the current example, every part of the walls has been inserted in the Walls layer, while all the doors and windows have been moved in the Windows and Doors layer. In addition, the dimensions have been moved in the Dimensions layer too. In the layer list, next to the layer's name, there are some icons. The first one, which is depicted by a light bulb, turns on and off the selected layer. When this icon is yellow, it means that the layer is on. Consequently, its objects are visible and available for plotting. On the contrary, if I click on it, the layer turns off and its objects are no longer visible nor can be plotted. I will hide the walls layer and notice how the walls were hidden from the drawing. Now we'll click again to turn the walls layer back on. If I click on the second icon, which looks like a sun, it becomes a snowflake and the layer freezes. This means that the objects of the frozen layer are not displayed, plotted, or regenerated. Notice that once I freeze the walls layer, the walls are no longer visible even though the layer is turned on. You can freeze the layers to improve performance and reduce the regeneration time in complex drawings. At this point, I will unfreeze the walls layer. Next to the freeze icon, there is a padlock icon. When the padlock is locked, the objects of the layer cannot be modified. I will lock the walls layer, so I will not accidentally move them while drawing. The printer icon controls whether the selected layers will be plotted or not. If I turn off the plotting for a layer, the objects on that layer are still visible, but they will not be printed. Note that layers that are turned off or frozen are not plotted, regardless of the plot setting. Next to those options, there are a few properties that can be changed, such as the color of the objects that are included in the layer, the line type, the line weight, and the transparency. In this example, I will change the color of furniture layer to brown and the color of the dimensions layer to gray. Then I will change the line weight of the walls to 0.30 mm. Notice that the width of the walls changed and the dimensions are now gray. As for the furniture's color, it didn't change, but this was to be expected since no objects have been moved to the furniture layer yet. The last thing I should mention is that the layer that has a check mark in the left of its name is the current layer, which means that everything that I'm going to draw from now on will be included in this layer. To change the current layer, I have to double-click on the name of the layer I wish to make current, or select it and click on the Set Current icon. Alternatively, I can right-click on the layer and select the Set Current option. In this example, I will select the Dimensions layer and I will click on the Set Current icon. Then, I will close the Properties palette, which I no longer need, and proceed to move its objects in the appropriate layer. If you take a look in the Layers panel of the Home ribbon, the current layer is shown when no object is selected. If I select an object, let's say the bed for example, the layer which the bed belongs to appears in the panel. At the moment, the bed, as well as the rest of the furniture, belong to the zero layer. To change that, I will select all the furniture first, and when I carefully make sure that I have selected them all, I will open the list and select the furniture layer. I will press Escape to unselect everything, and notice that now it's obvious that the furniture changed color according to the layer I moved them to. Lastly, I will create the bedroom's door, which is missing. First and foremost, I will press Escape to unselect all the objects, and then I will proceed to change the current layer to windows and doors. This time, instead of opening the layers palette, I will just open the list from the layers panel and select the windows and doors layer. That was another way to change the current layer. At this point, I will select the office's door and frame, and then I will activate the copy tool. I will specify the base point on the right corner of the door's frame, and then I will click on the right upper corner of the bedroom's wall to copy it. I will press Escape to exit the copy command. Notice that this door was also created in the windows and doors layer. So, to sum up, by separating the objects in different layers, we can change certain properties of the objects by changing the properties of the layer they belong to. Furthermore, it is easier to manage the objects of the same layer at once. Before we finish the lesson, I should mention that it's more convenient to create the layers in the beginning and draw the objects directly in the right layer than changing the layer of each object later.